So then, how are we getting to this sealed cave that I'm looking for? Therein lies a question. Also, what's this random pedestal? It's got some holy grease. Fine. So do we need to be down here, perhaps? Close to the water level? Yeah, this looks promising. Scarab as well. Oh, I still haven't swapped Wild Strikes onto my Claymore. Which I should probably do, because I do like it. Oh no, we're going down here, are we? Scarab's having a right old run. Gonna go around the circle, yep. And we're doubling back this way, I see. And we're heading back out, good. Now where are you going? Around the land squirts, that makes sense. I don't know if we're better off attacking with the old hard strikes or not. It's probably not even a scarab I'm going to use, because I'm going to guess it's a frost one. Oh no, it's prayerful strike. So yeah, it's not one we're going to use. I was going to guess it was a frost one just on the basis of the sort of blue footprints it was leaving behind. Shows what I know. Although it's prayerful strike. No, it's going to be faith, isn't it? It's not going to be lightning. It's only usable on axes and hammers anyway. Where do we get all the lightning ashes of war? Because I think they scale with strength. It might give us another string to our bow, as it were. That reminds me, we need to kill Radahn at some point sooner rather than later. Oops. And now our map's gone, so we can't get rid of this map marker, so let's do it the old-fashioned way. Precious item ahead, all the more seek material. Yep. That's a clue. And we're in what appears to be just an empty tunnel. How odd. So yeah, we can hear miners, but we can't see any entrances. So, I mean, there's obviously one here. Lovely. Although, should we have the bonk hammer out for this? Also, have we put any Ashes of War on the bonk hammer? Now, it's a big old place. We've got green crystals and also blue crystals. That was cool. The old plunge-o. Can we get back up there? Was that foolish? That was potentially foolish. I mean, we can teleport back up, can't we? So we may as well explore this bit. By the way, that other lad just doesn't care that I've just wrecked his mate. We got another pickaxe too. Cool. And there's a pest. I did not realise there were going to be pests down here. And good, we can just get back up. That's promising. Any more pests around? Seems not. And there we go. Smithing stone miners, bell bearing too. Oh yeah, guess we can leave. But wait, there's more. Now, what's this going to open up to? The usual drop off the side, maybe? Looks like it. And then, ooh, people died trying to get down there. Yes. Yes, they have. What if we go that way, though? I mean, that guy died at some point. Be wary of cliff. Yeah, yeah, obviously. So just flopping off gets you killed. Jumping off seems to get you killed. Yep. Yeah, it does. We had to check there, didn't we? We had to check that we weren't just watching incompetent people die, but there is in fact no way of doing it. Standard human behaviour, isn't it? It's like, well, everyone else has failed, but they were just stupid. I'm clever, so I'm not going to fail. And then we failed. And then we put on our shocked Pikachu face. So we could drop onto that cliff, I think. Onto that thing. Work our way across, perhaps. Yeah, we could make that jump. Time for jumping, but stay calm. We can stay calm. We can find our way down. There was another bit, though, so we might want the lift down here and then back up and then back down. But it looked like maybe just a somber, so it might not be worth the hassle. But we've got to check. Because we've got other characters that could use sombers. And it was actually a Smith and Stone 5. Good. That's useful. And then we get back down this way again. Hope. Lovely. And we've got more hidden wall. Grand. Do we have any in the opposite direction though as well? Because that would be a very FromSoft thing to do. Roots. And platforms. Platforms are our friend. Are you going to make it over here? Are you going to show me where it's safe to go? Or are you just going to hang out there? Right, so he's jumping up there. Still not doing much of any use to us. And he's jumping up there as well. Can they actually get me there? I'm going to say no, because now he's just standing there and throwing smoke bombs. Nice. And that's all them done. Just in time for Luna to jump on the back of my chair and try and eat my head. She is on a tear today. There's another one. Let's try and save some arrows. Oops. Ow. Awful little cat. Digging her claws into my skull whilst I'm trying to play the game. This is the true challenge run. Horrible little goblin. Yes, you are. You're a bigger pest than these lads in the mine, aren't you? But I can't seem to find any more with the old lock on, so. Joy. So let's drop onto this here wooden platform. See what's around and about. More of these gits. Okay. Wabam! He wasn't expecting wabam. And that's the price he pays. And thankfully, that seems to be a dead end. Hidden path ahead, you say? Methinks you're a liar. I could put down a liar ahead message, but it only takes people a second or two to check. So I'm not going to bother. Don't need to farm that comment karma. Now this is the trouble with the brick hammer, is that it's why I'm not using colossal weapons on anyone. It's just hard to see anything when the camera tightens up and you've got a massive weapon on your shoulder. Right, we've got a stake, that's reassuring, in a way. First off right and then hole. Thanks, friend. Yeah, I see what you mean. Then we've got those explodos. That's a big explodo. I wasn't expecting it to be quite so chonky. We'll take your ruined fragments. Are you not going to explode? There we go. Lazy bugger. Not a fan of these explodo balls. But what can you do, eh? Aside from trigger their explodos. What even are these things? Shame they don't trigger each other's explosions. Big old chain reaction of them would be fun. Got enough that they're going into our chest now. Break gem and use it to produce many magic bolts. Is that going to be useful? There's no point selling the buggers because they're probably worth like 100 runes apiece, so we may as well put them on our bar and then forget to use them at any stage. It's not like we've got a blue flask on there. So why not? Nice. And then hidden wall? Yeah. Seemed like a good spot for one. And yet deeper we go. Some more of these roots. I guess we're close to the earth tree proper, aren't we? So maybe these are... Well, we're quite a way away actually, but these might be earth tree related roots. Hey, oh Jesus Christ, I nearly botched it and then nearly overcorrected. Which would have been horrible all round. But we'll take your smith and stones. Now if we drop down that side there's an item. But would it be better than a smithing stone? Probably not. Ah, well. That's why there's a Steak America in here, I think. Now then, let's go get ourselves a talisman, shall we? Whoop. Lovely stuff. Top jumps all around. Now is it up this way? I forget. I did this, like, not very long ago. On someone, but I still forget. Now, where's that other bugger that jumps you if you're not cautious? Because it's those two. I'm sure there's another bugger. There he is. Where'd you come from? I tried to be cautious and we still failed. Mushroom. Wappa! Oops. Kick me, you son of a gun. Get out of my way, birds. That's my claw talisman. Yeah. They've added a new patch recently, which has slightly changed things around, although I don't think it's really nerfed jump attacks so much as it's buffed a bunch of other attacks. Is there any reason to be on this one? Other than to kill more bears? Probably not. Nah, don't think so. It's just a place to get yourself killed from fall damage, probably. Whoppa! Like so. That was foolish. But hey, at least we got our talisman. And we got the grind spot, so we didn't even need to go back and get those runes again. Although Sam is like lower level than everyone else by about 5 levels now. Which is a bit silly. But then she's one of the few characters who hasn't actually killed a second shard bearer, I think. So maybe that's a thing that should be done at some point. I'll probably get my runes back, if I can. It's only a short hop, skip and a jump. Well, it's a series of hops, skips and jumps. But that's fine. But yeah, they've released patch 1.04. Probably about 6 months ago by the time this is released. But there we go. And yeah, it's buffed colossal weapons a bunch apparently. That's where that lad came from. Oi! And apparently it's buffed incantations a bunch. You can cast a few of them without a stiff breeze knocking you over now. And yeah, they've improved the casting time of kick. Which is definitely noticeable already, I feel. Right then, my runes are over there, aren't they? Because, yeah. Because I was a very silly person indeed. At least we've gotten back without too much trouble. And now we can go and do something less stupid. Let's have a think. I mean, we do need to go and see Istvan. We should see how he feels about life at the moment. And then how he feels about it being ended for him. Is there something up with my controller all of a sudden? I seem to not be moving as comfortably as normal. Like I'm just stopping every now and again. I've been working this controller pretty hard over the last few weeks. But anyway, let's see what Istvan has to offer now. Ouch. That's not a colossal weapon he's using, is it? Because I'm not using colossal weapons on anyone, but they've been buffed to heck. So yeah, could be unfortunate if we run into any colossal peeps. Feels like we're running out of stamina pretty easily. Wait. Have we poisoned him? I think we have, you know. Good luck dealing with that, my man. Oh, we'll keep bleeding him. Oh god, have we run up against the invisible wall? Son of a bitch. And now, we're both out of flask. Yeah, maybe we should just let him do all the jumping attacks and then punish him when he misses. That might be a bit more sensible than just jumping in every time and getting nobbled. Feeling sick there, my friend? Thought so. And now, have we unlocked Radahn at this point? That's a question. Because I feel like we should have done, because we've been to Olsus, Yeah, so we could do Radahn. Don't know how that's going to work out for a melee user, but we're going to have to find out one day. We still need more arcane to build up our poison and our bleed, but we still need more vigor because who doesn't? Now, is there anything we could use those 2,500 runes for? We could buy more arrows from Carly. Or is that the lad who sells Ross arrows? Because they might be fun for something at some point. Sells the recipe for them, maybe. But then there's the lad who sells serpent arrows as well, isn't there? Maybe at some point we'll try re-cheesing that awful, awful bugger in Redmain once we've dealt with Radahn. I feel like staying on horseback is still the answer in the Radahn fight. Maybe we'll try a bit of Radahn not on horseback. Because otherwise there's no point in having two weapons, is there? Maybe we'll get in close, get off the horse, and see what we can do. But to begin with, we'll summon a bunch of dudes still, because otherwise, yeah, probably bad times abound. I feel like bad times abound either way, but we'll see. If we summon three people then? Summon Tregoth, we summoned Thingy. And we summoned Akia, good. Oops, we forgot to turn far enough. This will happen when we're taking forever to get into range. Here we go, he's looking for a fight now. Now, how's this going to work out? I mean, yeah, it's kind of tricky because we're still getting two shot if we're not careful. So horseback might be the answer. But we're doing decent damage getting in close like this. Akina's died, that's fine I guess. Yeah, I feel like horseback's the answer one way or the other. It's going so well. That's a bleed. It's probably about to disappear into the sky. Yep. Now, where are all our summon friends? Probably have a quick flask just in case. Because we don't know where he is or who he's landing on. Now we'll get some more friends back in the fight if we can. Where are they all? Go on, Alex, do your thing. You big slow pop. There they are. Come on, friends. That's Tregoth and Lionel back in. That was a big old hit. Which is the trouble. If we get hit more than once or twice, we die horribly. We need some more cannon fodder. Ah, jeez. That nearly one shot us, which means... yep. We're in trouble. He's on our butt by the look of things. And all our mates are dying again. Getting a hit and run? Not really. Where is everyone? Oh, we staggered him. It's probably about to meteor again. And nearly all of our friends are dead again. If not all of them. Yeah, there goes Tregoth. Dragos. I should know how to pronounce it by now. Patches told me. There goes Lionel. Where you at, homeboys? I haven't seen Jaren yet, have we? Oh, God. Safety flask. There's some friends. There's at least a couple of them back in the fight. There's lots more friends. Wow. Get in there, fodder. I mean, friends. Did he meet here again? I think he finally did. Pain in the ass that he is. Wow. Yay! So he's not so bad on horseback as melee. Good to know.
Let's meet where the flute take up our sword.
We certainly shall. I suppose we should speak to Alexander as well, even though he's a pathetic piece of crap.
Just you wait.
Ha ha ha, weirdo. Right. Let's go grab ourselves. Oh yeah, we should probably grab the Sight of Grace whilst it's right here. We'd also want to grab ourselves the catacombs, which is not right here. It's over here somewhere.